Hello students. So in this session we are going to discuss various constituents of iron carbon system. If you see the things what we have discussed in the previous session, so these are the things we have discussed in the previous session. So definition of phase and equilibrium diagram, and what is meant by equilibrium diagram, and what are the applications of equilibrium diagram, what we are going to learn, and what is the usefulness of this equilibrium diagram. So these things we have discussed in the previous session, and later we have discussed what is meant by a solid solution and types of solid solutions, substitutional solid solutions, interstitial solid solutions, and what is the difference between substitutional solid solutions and interstitial solid solution. And we have defined a chemical compound and a mechanical mixture, and the difference between a chemical compound and mechanical mixture. So these things we have discussed in the previous sessions, and later we have drawn the cooling curves for pure metal, alloy, and solid solution. And what is the difference between a cooling curve for pure metal and a solid solution and alloy, we have discussed. And we have discussed the solidification process and how it will be represented on a diagram, and what is meant by polymorphism, and what is allotropy, and what are the allotropic forms of pure iron, and how they can be represented on a cooling curve. Those things we have discussed in the previous sessions. So in this session we are going to discuss various constituents that exist in iron carbon system, and the crystal structures and the salient features of those elements. Okay, see here. First, we are going to discuss the various constituents. So what are the various constituents that are having in the iron carbon system? So we are having iron carbon alloy. In that one, we are having different constituents. So what are those various constituents? Those things we are going to discuss, and the crystal structure and the other salient features of those elements. So how the crystal structures will be for at different temperatures. So those things we are going to discuss in today's session. If you see here, this is very, very important. See, we are discussing polymorphism and allotropy. So in the last session also we have discussed polymorphism. So what is meant by polymorphism? If a material is having more than one crystal structure at a different temperatures, then it is known as, then the physical phenomena is known as polymorphism. So what is meant by polymorphism? If a material is having more than one crystal structures at different temperatures, okay, that physical phenomena is known as polymorphism. And later we have discussed allotropy, and which is related to your polymorphism. If the polymorphic change is reversible, then we can call it as allotropy. For example, if you take your iron carbon, if you take your what you can call allotropic forms of iron, and what are the different structures of a pure iron, and if you discuss the cooling curve for a pure iron, we are having different crystal structures at different temperatures. You are having delta iron, you are having gamma iron, you are having alpha iron. So at different temperatures you are having different crystal structures. You are having FCC, BCC, okay, and FCC, magnetic and non-magnetic. So if the process, so from top to bottom, when the crystal structure is a different, and if it is reversible from bottom to top also it is possible, then we can say it as allotropy. Okay, if you see here, iron changes its structure when heated. We know it, iron has the ability to exist BCC or FCC. See here, it may exist in BCC structure or it may exist in FCC structure based on the temperatures. So just now we have discussed polymorphism. In the polymorphism, so a material is having more than one crystal structure based on the temperatures. So here it is having BCC as well as FCC based on the temperatures. That means it is having polymorphism. Okay, and this ability, if the polymorphism is reversible, that means from temperature A to B you are coming and you are having different crystal structures. After some time, what you are doing, you are going from B to A, that means temperature B to A, and you are, whatever the things that happened from when you come from A to B, that means what are the crystal structures that formed, and it is reversible, that means when you are moving from B to A, and everything is possible, what happened when we come from A to B, that means reversible process is possible, then we can say that it is allotropy, it is having allotropic nature. That means that phenomena what we are observing is allotropy. So here in pure iron it is possible. When you draw a cooling curve for a pure iron, it is possible, right? So for that we are having allotropic forms of iron. So here we are going to discuss those allotropic forms of iron. So in the previous session also we have discussed allotropic forms of iron with respect to temperature. Okay, there we have taken in foreign degrees, here we are taking in degree centigrade. Okay, if you see I am taking temperature here, okay, I am taking time, and if I go for the temperatures, if you see here 1390 degree centigrade, so above 1390 degree centigrade, that green portion. So above 39 degree centigrade, what you are having? You are having delta iron. What you are having? You are having delta iron. See this one, delta iron. So what is the structure of this delta iron? It is BCC. What is the structure of this delta iron? BCC, body centered cubic. And if you go for this pink region, you are having, if you see the pink region, that is above 910 degree centigrade to 1390 degree centigrade, you are having gamma iron. See here, this gamma iron you are having. So what is the structure of this gamma iron? It is FCC. If you see delta iron forms ferrite with carbon, whereas gamma iron forms austenite with carbon. And if you see the yellow portion, okay, so up to 910 degree centigrade, up to 910 degree centigrade, you are having alpha iron, which is in BCC structure. Okay, so here it forms ferrite with carbon. If you see here, this is ferrite and this is ferrite, and here you are having austenite. Okay, so you are having alpha iron. So at different temperatures, if you take these temperatures, you are having delta iron, and if you take this temperature region, you are having gamma iron, and if you take this temperature region, you are having alpha iron. Okay, so based on the temperatures, you are having different crystal structures, BCC, FCC, BCC. Okay, so you are having BCC structure, later you are having FCC structure, and again you are having BCC structure. So the structure is changing with respect to temperature. So that phenomena, that physical phenomena, is known as polymorphism. Already we have discussed what is meant by allotropy. See here, initially we are moving in this direction, that means we are moving from top to bottom, that means we are cooling the liquid metal to solid. If I go from bottom to top, if I go from bottom to top, what will happen? So the process, that means initially you are having alpha iron, and when you heat and it reaches above 910 degree centigrade, then it will become gamma iron, and later it will become delta iron. That means whatever the process you are obtaining in the downward direction, it is repeated in the upward direction. So then we can call it as, that means reversible also possible. When the reversible is possible, the polymorphism is reversible, in the reverse direction is possible, we can say that it is it is following allotropic forms. That means it is following the phenomena known as allotropy. Okay, so that is known as allotropy, and here we are calling it as allotropic forms of pure iron. So what is this alpha iron or gamma iron or delta iron? Those are nothing but the allotropic forms of pure iron. Okay, I'm repeating once again. See here, we are taking liquid iron and we are going to cool it. When we cool up to 1390 degrees centigrade, so above 1390 degrees centigrade, what you are having delta iron, which is having BCC structure and it forms ferrite with carbon. So this is green portion. After that, if you further cool, what will happen when it reaches to 910 degrees centigrade? That means 910 degrees to 1390 degrees centigrade, in between this region. That means if you see the pink region in the diagram, so in this region it exists in the form of, so your pure iron exists in the form of gamma iron. So it is exist in the form of gamma iron, which is having FCC structure. And if you cool further, that is below 910 degrees centigrade, so it forms alpha iron, which is having BCC structure. And here it forms ferrite with carbon, whereas your gamma iron forms arsenide with carbon. Okay, so when you cool the liquid metal, what is happening at a different temperature ranges? It is having different crystal structures, BCC, FCC, and BCC, your delta iron, gamma iron, and alpha iron, right? So you are having different crystal structures at different temperatures. So this physical phenomena, what it is showing is known as polymorphism. That means it is having more than one crystal structures at different temperatures. If this polymorphism, what we are observing now, is reversible, that means when you move from here to here, that means when you move from 0 degrees to 1600 degrees centigrade, that means when you heat up to 910 degrees centigrade, so it will be in the alpha iron form. And if it reaches 910 degrees centigrade above, then it will converted into gamma iron. Later, if it reaches 1390 degrees centigrade above, then you are getting delta iron. So what is happening, whatever the things that obtained in the forward direction is also possible in the reverse direction. This phenomena is known as allotropy. Okay, so that's why we are calling as alpha, gamma, and delta irons are known as allotropic forms of iron. Okay, this is very, very important in the examination as well as competitive examinations, and you have to know the temperatures and you have to know the structures. Okay, those things are very, very important in the examination, and you have to remember them for forever, because in the competitive examinations everywhere they will ask these type of questions. Okay, and we'll go for the next one. If you see here, so what is alpha iron? Ferrite. So what is alpha iron? So alpha iron is, so we are going to discuss a different definitions here. See, it is a BCC crystalline form. So alpha iron, you have to remember, what is the crystal structure of alpha iron? So many times it is asked in the examinations. So what is the crystal structure of alpha iron? BCC crystalline form. And stable form of iron below 912 degrees centigrade, and the carbon percentage is 0.02%, and exists in solid solution. Okay, we are having different one, solid solutions, mechanical mixtures, chemical compound, right? So it is exist in the solid solution. So it is having BCC crystalline structure, right? And it is having, that means it is having stable form of iron below 912 degrees centigrade, and 0.02% of percentage of carbon it is having. It exists in solid solution. Okay, so it is also known as ferrite. That means ferrite alpha iron is present. See this one. So already we have discussed this one elaborately in the previous sessions, but once again we have to see. See, this is the stick model of a body-centered cubic, okay, BCC structure. So in the BCC structures, what you are having, 8 corner atoms. One, if you see here, one, I will show you. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 corner atoms you are having, and one center atom. So at the body center, at the center you are having one atom. So 8 corner atoms will provide 1/8 × 8. So that means it will provide effective number of atoms as 1, because at each corner atom that atom is shared by 8 unit cells. That means 1/4 of the atom will present for unit cell. So 1/8 × 8 atoms are 8 corners are there. So 1/8 × 8. So you will get effective number of atom 1, and in at the center you are having one more atom. That means 1 + 1, 2. Effective number of atoms, how many? 2 effective number of atoms. So if you see the actual diagram, this is a stick model, and if you see this with atoms, so this is the BCC structure. So we are having 8 atoms, see here, and one more that side, and this is the center atom. So you are having 8 corner atoms and one center atom. So in this one we will find out the effective number of atoms. These things, it is very very important, this BCC structure. And example for BCC structure, just now we have discussed, that is alpha iron. Okay, see here, this is the BCC structure. If you observe this one, so for easy understanding, they have shown here. If you see this one, this is 1/8 portion. This is 1/8 portion. Like that, how many are you are having? 8 you are having. Okay, so 8 you are having, 8 and 1/8 portion. Okay, so 8 × 1/8. How much you are going to get? 1, and you are having center atom 1. So 1 + 1. How many you are getting? Effective number of atoms 2. So total effective number of atoms you are going to get as 2. Okay. So this portion is only 1/8 portion, this one. So like that, at 8 corners you are having 1/8 portion. So 8 corners × 1/8, so that gives 1. At the center you are having one atom, so 1/8 × 8 + 1 gives effective number of atoms 2. Very very important question, effective number of atoms in BCC structure. See here, if you observe this one is very very important for a competitive exam point of view. If you see, this is the center atom, these are the corner atoms, and you have corner atoms this one. So if A is the side of the cube, if A is the side of the cube, then this parameter and this parameter, these parameters are very very important. Okay, just you remember these parameters. Okay, these parameters are not interested in these parameters here, because in diploma level we are not having such depth of knowledge, we don't require such depth of knowledge here, because we are interested in the basics concepts of BCC, FCC. But in the competitive exams and gate exams, you have to know these values. Based on these values, they will give some problems also. Okay, so these parameters are very very important for the competitive examinations. So you have to learn, you will learn these things in the higher studies regarding this A and R, and how the relation will be for different parameters. Those things you will learn in the higher studies, and those are very very important for the competitive examination point of view. And if you see here, next one is gamma iron. Okay, if you see the gamma iron or austenite, it is in the form of austenite. So here you are having austenite, so you are gamma iron. So what is the structure? FCC, face centered cubic. So the face centered cubic is having high formability and high solubility of carbon. So the percentage of carbon will be, it is more than 2% of carbon can be dissolved in it, and that it will be stable at 1148 degree centigrade and begins with a single phase at this one. Okay, so these are the few points regarding your gamma iron. Okay, so it is having FCC structure and high formability and high solubility of carbon will be there, over 2%, and it can be dissolved it. And 1148 degrees centigrade, the heat treatment begins with the single phase. So these things you have to, in the heat treatment we will discuss very clearly regarding austenite. See, these structures we have discussed elaborately in the previous sessions, but once again we will recollect whatever what the things we have discussed. If you see here, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 corner atoms you are having. For this phase, this is one atom. For this phase, this one. For the top phase, this one. For the bottom phase, for this phase, this one. For the bottom phase, this one. For this phase, this one. Okay. So all the phases, 6 phases you are having. Okay. So you are having 6. You are not having this one. This is wrong. Okay. So you are having 6 phases. Okay. So 8 corner atoms at the 8 corners. And 6 you are having, for a cube you are having 6 faces and 6 face atoms. Okay, so half of the portion will be inside and half of the portion will be outside. That means for a atom, half of the portion belongs to this unit cell. Okay, I will show you. So this is the pattern, and if you FFCC crystal structures, they are tightly packed. Okay, see here, this portion, this portion, how many faces are there? 6 faces. Okay, so what is the effective number of atoms for this one? So corner atoms, how many you are having? 1/8 portion will be shared. And how many corner atoms you are having? 8. So 8 into 1/8, that will give 1. And how many faces you are having? 6 faces you are having. Each face is having half atom. So half into 6, how many? 3. So 3 + 1, how much you are going to get? 3 + 1, that is 4 effective number of atoms in a FCC structure. See here. See this one. I will show you very clearly. See this one. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 corner atoms you are having. And if you observe, see, for this phase, this one, for this phase, this one, for this phase, bottom, this one, and for this phase, this one, and for this phase, this one, for the top phase, this one. How many symbols are here? Hot symbols are there? 6. So how many faces you are having? 6 faces. If you observe, how much atom you are having? How much atom? Half atom. How much atom having you are having at the corner? 1/8 portion. Here you are having 1/8 portion. Here you are having half. Okay. So how many corners you are having? 8. So 1/8 into 8 plus how many faces you are having? 6. For each face, how many atoms are there? Half atom. So 6 into half. So how much you are going to get? 8 into 1/8 plus 1 plus 6 into 1/2. That is 3. So 1 + 3, how much you are going to get? It is 4. So here you are going to get, I will show you. So what you are, how you are going to get? See, 1/8 into 8 plus how many corner atoms, face atoms are there? 6. How much portion will be there? 1/2. So this will become 1, and this will become how much? This one, 3. So how much you are going to get? 1 plus 3, that is 4. Okay. So in this way, the effective number of atoms will be 4. Okay. See. So similarly, what we have discussed in the BCC unit cell. So the parameters A, 4R, root A. So these things you have to know for competitive exams purpose, and you will learn these things in the higher studies. Okay. Just for understanding purpose, I have given this one. Okay. No need to enter into the detailed, but they are very useful for the competitive exams. Okay. So for that time, you have to be thorough with the parameters. Next, delta iron. So how the delta iron will be? See here, delta iron presents at extreme temperatures 1490 degrees centigrade. Maximum carbon dissolved can be 0.08%. And cementite, iron carbide. So what is the other name for cementite? Fe3C. So that is iron carbide. So what is cementite? It is the stoichiometric intermetallic compound, and it is hard and brittle, and we are unable to know the exact melting point. So this is the nature of cementite, Fe3C. Okay. So iron carbide. So it is nothing but intermetallic compound, which is having hard and brittle nature, and the exact melting point of that cementite is not known. See, Curie point. So we know what is Curie point. So Curie point is nothing but at what temperature the magnetic properties change. That means whether it becomes from magnetic to non-magnetic or non-magnetic to magnetic. So that temperature is known as Curie point. Okay. So here we are having alpha iron is having both magnetic and non-magnetic, right? So at what temperature it is becoming non-magnetic to magnetic transition, that temperature is known as Curie point. So what is a Curie point? Atomic level non-magnetic to magnetic transition, that temperature is known as Curie point. See, next, perlite. So these definitions are very, very important. Perlite. So what is meant by perlite? We are going to discuss here. If you see here in perlite, so perlite is an intimate mixture of ferrite and cementite. Okay. So this is very, very important for exam point of view. They will ask, define what is define perlite. Okay. So here, and it will be asked frequently in the competitive examinations. What is meant by perlite? A, B, C, D. They will give different combinations. See, it is an intimate mixture of ferrite and cementite. Okay. So ferrite and cementite mixture is known as perlite. So in perlite, what you are having? You are having ferrite and cementite. So it has a distinct lamellar structure. Which type of structure it is having? Lamellar structure. Okay. So we are going to discuss these structures in the coming sessions. So just remember the word lamellar structure. It will be having a lamellar structure consisting of alternate layers of your ferrite and cementite. So what is the mixture you are having here? You are having a mixture of ferrite and cementite, and here you are having alternate layers of ferrite and cementite. So when you lay this alternate layers of ferrite and cementite, it will look like a lamellar structure, and that structure exists in the perlite structure. Okay. So, and if you see here, it is an eutectic phase transformation. It is eutectic phase transformation of austenite at 723 degrees centigrade at 0.03% of carbon. Okay. So here at this stage, it is very difficult to understand this terminology, but just remember, we are going to discuss all this. What is meant by eutectide and what is meant by eutectic? Okay. And what is meant by austenite and the percentage of carbon and the temperatures? Okay, when we enter into the iron carbon equilibrium diagram, then we can learn each and everything. Okay, so just here you remember it is the when you are going to get this perlite. So when the austenite undergo eutectic phase transformation, so eutectide phase transformation takes place at 720 degree centigrade at the percentage of 0.83%, then you are going to get perlite. So perlite is nothing but a mixture of ferrite and cementite. So simply you may remember, so perlite is nothing but it is the phase transformation. Which type of phase transformation? Eutectide phase transformation of austenite at 723 degree centigrade with carbon percentage of 0.83%. And when the phase transformation takes place, you are going to get perlite. So what you are having in the perlite, you are having ferrite and cementite. Which type of structure it is having? Lamellar structure. In the lamellar structure, how it will look like? So you are having alternate layers of ferrite and cementite. So this one is sufficient. Okay. So how you are going to get perlite? At what temperature? At what composition? What you are having in that one? And what is the structure? Sufficient. Okay. So that is regarding perlite. And next, leduberite. This is also very, very important. Leduberite. Okay, what do you understand by leduberite and how you are going to get this leduberite? Very, very important in the examinations, academic examinations as well as competitive examinations. This is very, very important. Okay, so whatever the new terminology we are getting, you should be able to understand it carefully and how to remember it forever and properly. That is very, very important. You may remember now, but you may forget after some time. Okay. But you have to by heart, or you have to remember it in such a way that you should not forget forever. Okay. Then only you are able to answer those type of questions in the competitive examinations. Otherwise, it is very difficult. They are very confusing in nature. These type of questions are very confusing in nature because all seems are similar. All the terms seems similar, and the percentages and the forms, everything you have to remember carefully. You have to practice them. See, leduberite, if you see the leduberite, so leduberite is a mixture of austenite and cementite. Okay. So what is a leduberite? Leduberite is a mixture of austenite and cementite. And if you see this one, what is this perlite? It is a mixture of ferrite and cementite. What is happening here? Austenite and cementite. Okay. So you should be very careful in remembering these terms and the combinations and the mixtures, but their constraints. Otherwise, it is very difficult and they are very confusing to answer in the examinations. Okay. So if you see this one, if you see, it is a mixture of austenite and cementite, and it is obtained by eutectic phase transformation. There, eutectoid. Here, eutectic phase transformation of liquid alloy containing 4.3% of carbon below 1148 degree centigrade and below 723 degree centigrade, leduberite changes into perlite. So those things, these things at this temperature, we will understand thoroughly when we discuss the iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Okay, just here you remember the temperatures and the percentages and the phase transformation, how it will be done and what is the mixture, those things you remember. Okay, I'm repeating once again, leduberite is nothing but it is a mixture of austenite and cementite. So how you are going to get this leduberite? It is the eutectic phase transformation. So what is meant by eutectic reaction, eutectoid reaction? So you will get some reactions. Those reactions will be discussed elaborately in the iron carbon equilibrium diagram. So when we discuss iron carbon equilibrium diagram, we are going to discuss these things elaborately. Here you just remember what is meant by that eutectic phase transformation and eutectide phase transformation in the previous one. Okay, no need to enter what is meant by eutectic phase transformation, what is meant by eutectoid phase transformation. So those things you are going to learn when we study the iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Okay, so it is a mixture of austenite and cementite. How you are going to obtain it? By eutectic phase transformation of liquid alloy, which is containing 4.3% of carbon, and it can be cooled below 1148 degrees centigrade. And if you cool further at 723 degrees centigrade, this lead operite will be changed into perlite. Okay, those things you have to remember. Okay, this slide, a small slide, but which gives more information. That means, so what is the mixture? So you may get one question from this one. Lead operite is a mixture of. So you may have four options. Okay, so which phase transformation will occur in the lead operite formation? So you may have eutectoid, eutectic, hyper eutectoid, so many. Okay, so you are having different reactions you are having, and what is the percentage of carbon? So anything may be asked in the examination. Okay, you have to remember them carefully. And coming to next slide, see microstructure of iron carbon at a different compositions. So at different composition, how it will be? See this one, very very important. See here. So this is iron carbon equilibrium diagram, but it is just outline. Okay, as a mechanical engineer, we should know iron carbon equilibrium diagram. If you are interested in engineering applications, you should be thorough with this iron carbon equilibrium diagram. That means if you are interested, for example, if you take DMRL, DRDO, and your Midhani, RCI, ARCI, so you are having so many companies, so many organizations, government organizations, research organizations, those are working on the materials processing, and they are studying on the preparation of alloys and studying the properties of alloys and compositions. Okay, so if you want to work in this field, if you if you are interested in those fields, you should be thorough in this iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Okay, so this is the outline. If you see this one, this is the outline of a iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Okay, but here we are not interested with the different temperatures, so this is just outline. Here we are taking the carbon percentage on x-axis, and the y-axis you are taking the temperature. We will discuss elaborately in the coming sessions. Here just we are discussing the microstructure of the carbon system at different compositions. Okay, so different compositions means when it is moving from here to here, that means the composition of carbon is changing. That means here we are taking the percentage of carbon. So here the percentage of carbon is less, and when you are moving this side, the percentage of carbon is increasing. Okay, so here at this point you are having 100% ferrite, almost pure iron you are having. See the microstructure, and if you see the second microstructure, here you are having perlite and ferrite. Just now we have discussed what is meant by a perlite, how it will be formed, and if you move towards this side, what you are having? You are having 100% perlite and eutectoid, 100% perlite. So what do you mean by this eutectoid mixture? Okay, 100% perlite, that means complete perlite will be there. Complete perlite, what is meant by perlite? It is a mixture of ferrite and cementite. So complete, you are having ferrite and cementite mixture at this position. Okay, and if you see here, iron carbide and perlite. So at this composition you are having, if you see the microstructures, the microstructure also different. And at this composition you are having iron carbide and perlite. Okay, so but if you see, the structure will be different, the structure will be different. So in this way, so here we are studying only few concepts, that is how the microstructure of your carbon system, okay, iron carbon system will differ, okay, at different compositions. When you are having low carbon, how the microstructure will be. When you are having the carbon percentage is increased, how the structure will be. So those things we are having. Okay. So if you see here 100% ferrite and you are having 100% perlite plus ferrite, you are having 100% perlite, iron carbide plus perlite and iron carbide perlite, and you are having different structures. So these things we will learn in detail in the iron carbon equilibrium diagram. So what are the things we have discussed in this session. Okay, so we will see here. So these things we have discussed in this session. First one is alpha iron, gamma iron are the interstitial solid solutions. Okay, your ferrite and austenite are the interstitial solid solution, whereas ferrite iron is having BCC crystal structure, gamma iron is FEC crystal structure, and delta iron is having BCC crystal structure. Perlite, lead barite are the mechanical mixtures. So this one also very, very important. Okay, I will show you. See, this one examples for mechanical mixtures are perlite and lead barite. So there will be no chemical reaction. So you are having a mechanical mixture. Your perlite and lead barite. Perlite is nothing but ferrite plus cementite, whereas your lead barite means austenite plus cementite. So they are the mechanical mixtures. They are together. Okay. So that is mechanical mixtures. And cementite, this is Fe3C, it is a chemical compound. See here, if you observe this one, all three types of things we are having. We have discussed solid solutions. In that one, you are having interstitial solid solutions and substitutional solid solutions. So your alpha iron, that is your ferrite and austenite, are nothing but the interstitial solid solutions. And we come from perlite and lead barite, they are the mechanical mixtures, and cementite is a chemical compound. And we know that the allotropic forms of pure iron, that is alpha iron, gamma iron and delta iron. So at different temperatures, it is having different crystal structures like BCC, FCC crystal structures. Okay. And we have discussed the effective number of atoms for BCC crystal structures and FCC crystal structures. See here. So these are the examples. Ferrite is the having BCC crystal structure, and your gamma iron is having FCC crystal structure. Your delta iron is having BCC crystal structure. So for BCC crystal structure, how many effective number of atoms? How many effective number of atoms are there for BCC crystal structure? So for BCC crystal structure, we are having two number of effective number of atoms. That means you are having 8 corner atoms. 8 into each corner atom, you are having 1/8 portion of the atom for the unit cell. So 8 into 1/8 plus at the center you are having one atom. So 1/8 into 8 plus 1, you are going to get effective number of atoms 2. For FCC crystal structure, you are having at the 8 corners 8 atoms. So each corner atom is having 1/8 portion for that unit cell. Right, so 1/8 into 8, that gives 1, and you are having 6 faces for a cubic structure. So 6 faces means each face is having one atom, and half atom is shared by one unit cell. So half into 1/6, that gives 3. So 3 plus 1, how much you are getting? 4. So 4 is the effective number of atoms for your FCC crystal structure. Later we have discussed definition, that means what is meant by perlite. So what is the mixture and how it will be formed, and at what temperature and at what composition it will be formed, and lead barite definition, what is the mixture and what are the constraints you are having in the lead barite mixture, and at what temperature and how it will be formed. So we have gone through the terms eutectide phase transformation and eutectic phase transformation. You are going to discuss these eutectic eutectide reactions in the iron carbon equilibrium diagram. Just you remember the words here, that's sufficient. And later we have discussed what is meant by a cementite, how it will be formed, and what is the nature of a cementite, right? So those things we have discussed. And at the end, we have gone for the skeleton form, that means outline of iron carbon equilibrium diagram. In that iron carbon equilibrium diagram, we have discussed the different forms of carbon, iron carbon system at different compositions. So at different composition of carbon, how the structure and how the composition, that means how the microstructure will be. So you are having 100% ferrite, and later you are having a mixture, you are having 100% perlite. Okay, so you are having perlite and you are having perlite, like that, how it is varying based on the composition. So we have discussed. So we will discuss those things in detail in the coming sessions in the iron carbon equilibrium diagram. No need to worry here again, but you have to remember the words, temperatures, and the compositions. It is very difficult to remember in one glance. Okay, you have to practice, then only you are able to remember those things, because it is a confusing concepts, because every term seems to be similar and the percentages will confuses in the examinations. Okay, and most of the questions may be asked from these topics, because it is very confusing and very vast. We can say vast in the sense for on every point they may ask a question, they frame a question. So for that purpose, you have to remember them carefully and perfectly. Perfection is important here. Okay, speed and accuracy, both are important here. When you attempt a competitive examination, speed as well as accuracy, both should be there. Otherwise, you are unable to win the competitive examinations. Okay, if you see, if you go for the quiz, if you see ferrite, so what is the structure of a ferrite? So how the structure of a ferrite will be? So what is the structure of a ferrite? Just now we have discussed. What is that one? BCC crystal structure. And if you see, austenite is having which type of crystal structure? FCC crystal structure. Okay, just now we have discussed. So ferrite is BCC, austenite is FCC. Very, very important questions. See this one. If you see the short questions, explain ferrite with crystal structures. So ferrite, how, what is meant by ferrite, and what is the crystal structure? Those things we have to explain. What is the crystal structure? BCC. Austenite with this crystal structure. So how you are going to get austenite, and what is the crystal structure? FCC. And what is meant by mechanical mixtures? Already we have discussed these mechanical mixtures. Okay, so those things you have to write here, and list out various mechanical mixtures exist in iron carbon system. So what are those? Perlite and ledoberite. So perlite and ledoberite are the mechanical mixtures that exist. So what is meant by perlite and what is meant by ledoberite, and those things you have to explain. So if it is asked for 1 marks, just you answer in single line. If it is asked for 3 marks, you write some points regarding that perlite and ledoberite. And if you see here, discuss about cementite. So how a cementite will look like, and how it will be formed, and what is the nature of cementite, whether it is brittle or like that with hard, those things we have to discuss here. And if you see this one, discuss in detail various constituents element exist in iron carbon system. So what are the different things that exist in iron carbon system? So we have to explain in detail. So that means the complete chapter what we have discussed, those things should be explained in various forms. And discuss reasons why different crystal structures exist in iron carbon system. Okay, so at different crystal structures will exist at different temperatures based on the composition. Just now we have discussed in the last slide. Okay, so different structures, you are having ferrite, 100% ferrite, and you are having perlite, 100% perlite, and you are having a mixture, you are having cementite. So you are having at different compositions, you are having different things. Those things should be discussed by using this diagram. Okay, so these are the questions that may be asked generally in the examination. Okay, and if you see here, So these are the questions that may be asked in the examination. So with this one, I am closing today's session, and we will discuss in detail in the coming sessions regarding iron carbon equilibrium diagram and other parameters related to iron carbon equilibrium diagram.